Katie. I did my undergrad at Virginia Tech, and then I came down here, and I'm getting a doctoral degree, and I was actually able to roll through the master's, which was something that was appealing to me. I'm working with Dr. Schufel. He's my major professor, and that was actually a big draw for me coming here also. But I'm co-working with Dr. Pegg on a project on pecans and their nutraceutical and anti-inflammatory properties.
Cool. Hi, I am Chandeep Sidhu from India. Got my undergrad there in food technology. It was an engineering degree. Then I worked in the food industry in a candy plant. And that was like a little over a year that I worked. And then I decided to get my master's and apply to various schools and got an admit from UT, a couple of others, but finally selected University of Georgia.
Hi, I'm Audrey. I got my undergraduate degree in chemical engineering at the University of Maryland. I'm currently getting my master's in food science under the advisement of Dr. Kerr in food processing. My research involves using a vacuum belt dryer, which is another novel technology. It's not too frequently used, and I'm drying some different vegetables.
My name is Yi. I'm originally from China. I got my bachelor's degree in food science from China, and now I'm working on my PhD degree with Dr. Pak. And my research is about food chemistry. It's on the cytochemicals of the pecans, and its impact. Study for the impact of the different horticultural aspects. And we're gonna, through this project, we're gonna provide like stable price and good quality pecans to export all over the world.
Hi, my name is Susie. I'm from Korea, and I did my undergrad in Korea, and I'm getting my master's in here. I'm working with Dr. Mohan, and currently I'm working on meat tenderization with chemical agents. And in light of advancements in food science, and it's varied in a variety of culture, I think it's really worth to be here, and I'm really enjoying being here.
Hello, I'm Sophia. I'm originally from Spain. I did my undergrad in Spain. Then I was working in the industry for a couple of years, and then I did my master's in the Netherlands. And then I came to the University of Georgia. And I'm actually working in food microbiology, specifically with Salmonella species and mathematical models that predict the behavior of Salmonella in dry food.
I chose to come here because of the collaboration available within departments. So my first project, I actually worked very closely over in the horticulture department, and my current pecan project with the anti-inflammatory and the cell culture, I've been given a great opportunity to go and work in pharmacy. So I really like the multifaceted dimensions of my project and getting to interact with people that are, you know, outside this department, but still getting a degree.
Yeah.
I've been doing some work recently over at the USDA, over on College Station. So I think Athens gives a great opportunity to be able to interact not just within academia, but also industry. We seem to have a lot of industry contacts.
Yeah,
right.
And like even within the department, there are a lot of disciplines you can go into. Mm-hmm. There's like tons of professors and students with different interests.
I chose food science department here at UGA because it had well-recognized faculty members, and then it had student-centered programs, and it had a very variety of facilities, like high-tech facilities and laboratories.
E, what brought you down here from up in Missouri? What was the biggest draw?
Biggest draw?
Yeah.
The program here is bigger, and they have national recognized professors in here, and they have very good facilities. Like we have food processing labs, we have food chem labs, and also we have food micro labs down to the Essence. Down to the Griffin campus. So we have all sorts of things like combined in the food science that you needed to study.
It's also because Georgia is a high food producer, right? I mean, I think it's the number one chicken producing state.
Number one pecan producing state.
Pecan, peanuts. So there's a lot.
Yeah.
Because of the Georgia production, the funding opportunities that are available to the university based on those products are greater than you would find in other states. I mean, they're for almost all commodities, there's Georgia, blank commission, you know, agricultural commission, and they have funding available, and they are funding a lot of different projects here, and so that connection is definitely huge. I've been interviewing a fair amount lately, and when I go and say that I am a UGA doctoral student, the feedback that I get is always very positive and impressed. So I don't even, I mean, I am proud, but I don't even have to be proud because it's like, oh, yes, you know, yeah. Go Bulldogs. You guys are always knowledgeable and organized and well put together.
I think there were two rankings posted on the notice board recently, one last year, one this year. And UGA's PhD program in particular was ranked in the top five. Mm-hmm. Last year was like top two or three.
Like all the students here, even before I accepted to come to Georgia, everyone is so friendly, and all of the students in the department are very passionate. That even was reflected after I decided to attend the University of Georgia. One of the alumni from the food science department here sent me a letter saying he was so happy. And at the food science club, there's a lot of people that are pretty engaged. Everyone's friendly, passionate, and I've had a lot of fun. We do plenty of little side projects. It's not only our research, and what's great about food science is you always get to eat your project, assuming it's food safe.
Yes.
Yeah, it's more in the processing and less on the chemistry end.
Yes.
and the microbiology. There's not as much eating in our
eat a lot.
Don't eat a lot either.